SAISD students. I'm an SAISD student too. I went to SAISD many years ago. My name is Carmen Tafoya. I'm a writer and a poet. I've written more than 30 books, and a whole bunch of them are about poetry. I'd like to share with you today some secrets about writing poetry, because some people think that poetry is very hard and you have to know some magical thing in order to make it happen, and that's not true. A famous poet, E.E. Cummins, said, "Whenever you think or you know or you believe, you're a whole bunch of other people. But whenever you feel, you're nobody but yourself." And writing poetry is about being nobody but yourself, being very honest about who you are, what you feel, what your experiences and emotions are, what your perspective is, because you're unique. You have something to contribute that nobody else has. You see through your own eyes and you have your own experience. And being different is not a bad thing, especially in poetry. So I want to share with you some ideas. Sometimes poetry is like painting a picture, only you're painting a picture with words. You're putting down what a person looks like and sounds like, and maybe it's about somebody you like, maybe it's about somebody you hate, maybe it's about somebody you think is funny. Maybe there's a guy that walks in class all the time, he always has a hair sticking up in back, he always says, "Hey, man," it says the same thing every day, and he always has his hair sticking up. Well, that's the beginning of a poem right there. You could say, "Hey, man," he says, as he walks in the classroom, his hair sticking up and his shoulders down, a cloud of the smell of freshly toasted flour tortillas all around him, coming straight from his grandmother's comal. You know, that's the beginning of an image of a person. Or you can write about a place, and all it has to be is what you feel or think. You can learn about metaphor from your teacher, and you can make it a richer descriptor. You can find better words, but there's really no one who can tell you what to write about except you. And you're full of all kinds of stories. You talk to your friends every day. I wrote a lot about the people of San Antonio, but I also wrote about the place. In fact, one of my books is all poems about the spirit of San Antonio. It's called This River Here. And I'm going to share with you one of the poems that comes from this, because we come from a very special city. I'm really in love with this city. In fact, this is one of my favorite pictures of, it's from the back of my first book of poetry. It was called Get Your Tortillas Together. And I'm there with my two co-authors in front of one of my favorite tortillerias. But if you look around San Antonio, you're going to find all these cultures and all these signs and billboards that are found poetry. They have things already that sound like a poem. This one's called De Volada Insurance, Faster Than a Flying Chancla, The Signs of San Antonio. Drive through these streets, or better yet, walk. You will encounter alien worlds that don't even lift an eyebrow here. Billboards, store windows, signs on a closed door, graffiti on train cars, even family histories that record your parents met at El Burrito Bar, El Patron's Tire Rental, Juan in a Million, Porky's Burgers y Mas, Pancho Villa Tacos, Got Tacos? Witness. De Volada Insurance, Faster Than a Flying Chancla, El Rey Feo Scholarship Fund, and No Alcohol or Barbecue Allowed in This Park. El Divino Salvador United Methodist Church. Pronto Pawn, We Buy Guns, Closed on Sundays. Do or Die Hair Salon, Chicanos United Alamo Chapter. And even if you drive south to get out of town, the news on Texas Public Radio 89.1 begins to be punctuated with Conjunto Acordeon coming in and out every time the car goes up on a hill. It's competing for reception with La Lupe 89.1, Rio Bravo, Mexico, which plays Solo la mano de Dios podrá separarnos. And Where, oh, where can my baby be? In perfect Spanish translation. And after a while, it all sounds like the same channel. So here you have a poem about the same channel of San Antonio that is music and radio stations and billboards and signs. It's anything that helps create a description of your life. Whether the life is, this teacher says I only have 2 hours of homework, and that teacher says I only have 2 hours of homework, and the other teacher says I only have 2 hours of homework, and there, I'm not even sleeping anymore. So have fun, write your poems. Thanks for being with us.